Next, why Al Jazeera News is willing to spend a reported $500 million on a little watch cable network in the U.S. Ray Suarez reports.
Robert Wheelock is the executive producer of News Gathering for Al Jazeera in the Americas, and he joins us now. Well, with price tags conservatively estimated north of $500 million, that's a lot of money for a channel watched by very few people. What did Current have that Al Jazeera needed?
Access. Access across this country, across the United States, something that we've tried in various forms to gain. And this availability and this opportunity came, and I must say, you know, the editorial board and the management of the company very aggressively pursued this, but not, you know, not without knowledge that there's risk.
Can you be sure that you're going to keep that access if cable operators can now re-examine their agreements and say, well, it's not Current anymore, maybe we don't want to run it anymore?
We think so. Look, obviously, people have done market research. People have checked some things. We know, for instance, that we have a very large traffic on the web, and 40% of that is driven from the United States. So there's an appetite. There's interest. We don't buy. I don't buy into the edict that Americans aren't interested in international news. Americans don't have enough international news available to them. So they watch what's available. We offer an alternative. It's a broader coverage of news. It's a broader spectrum into countries that aren't traditionally covered. And we'll increase, accordingly, also our coverage of American news and in Latin America, which we're quite proud of that coverage.
It's interesting that you say that, because this is a time when people are actually watching less news on television. They are looking to television less often. This is educated adults to get a picture of what's going on in the world. And here you are, entering an already crowded marketplace.
Again, maybe they're watching less because what they see is the same. Channel after channel after channel. People have 800 channels to choose from. We do offer something that's different. We offer what we believe is editorially correct content, not politically correct. We offer, as I said, coverage in countries that other networks are not invested in. We have 71 bureaus around the world. We're proud of that. We're proud that we're in Timbuktu, we're in Peru. We cover stories that you won't see everywhere else. Is all the world going to tune in and watch Al Jazeera on any one night? No. But can we get a good hunk of that? We think we can, and we think our content speaks for itself. And we've got a reputation now as a good news provider.
When CCTV signed on, there were questions about editorial independence because it's a property of the Chinese government. Can we ask the same questions about Al Jazeera, since it is owned by a foreign entity and with a direct managerial pipeline from the royal family?
You can, and you are. And it's been asked repeatedly. Again, I think the content speaks for itself. We won a number of awards. Last year, the RTS, Royal Television Society, gave us a cable network of the year. That was a big deal for us. The BBC was based in England. Did that mean they were only, you know, that they were driven by English coverage? CNN started in Atlanta. Did they have a bias towards the South? No. You know, that happens to be where we're headquartered. It happens to be where the impetus for this came from. But this is a long-time plan for global expansion. We have a Balkans network. We have a Swahili network. We're playing a Turkish network. We have children's programming and sports. This is obviously a key and very much needed part to that expansion.
But you're best known, or co-best known, if that's a word, for the Arabic language service. And people who watch this very closely, who've made academic study of it, say they're two very different kettles of fish, Al Jazeera in Arabic and Al Jazeera in English. How are they different? And how would you explain that to an American who has heard a lot of things that haven't been so complimentary about the Arabic language service?
The difference is, you know, who's your audience? To be honest, it's, you know, it's targeted towards an audience, and the coverage. We rely on Arabic for some material too. They rely on us. We share some facilities. Editorially, we do have different takes on things. We're doing things for the Americas. They're doing things for the Middle East. It's the allegations that, you know, we're corrupted in our views. It's interesting. Everybody, and I only hear this from people, never directly, but it's always sort of referred. But it's never referred to with any instance or by people who say, you know, here's an example. Mm-hmm. You know, they haven't watched it. I've always said, and it sounds a little corny, if you watch us, you're going to like us. You're going to find it interesting. Now we'll have an opportunity for more people to watch us. And that's been what we've been missing.
Robert Wheelock of Al Jazeera, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. I appreciate it.